So that is the first approach, or the first part of this video. So the next part, I'm going to show you how to convert the decimal degrees into UTM coordinates. So decimal degrees into UTM coordinates. So for now, I'm not going to use this worksheet. I'm going to select this decimal degrees to UTM here. Okay, so this is what we have. Again, do we have any other settings that we need to set? Of course, it is there. As you can see, you have the hemisphere. You need to set the hemisphere. So for now, of course, by default, it is in southern hemisphere. But if you are living in the northern hemisphere, just click this down menu. So just click this menu here and select your northern hemisphere. But for me, I'm living in the southern hemisphere. Then I'm going to select. We are going to do the same thing. First thing first, let me select a few coordinates. Degrees coordinates. Let me select a few first. Okay, so latitude, longitude, so let me select a few. And again, from here, let me paste my coordinates here. Okay, but because I have only few coordinates, I don't have to go and unhide the hidden columns, because everything now is okay. But if you have more, then you need to go and unhide the hidden columns. For now, I assume that I have only these few coordinates. So if you have few coordinates, then I'll just select my converted coordinates here. I'm not very sure if, okay, my coordinate. So this is what I have. And then I need to copy it and paste it here. Okay, so the next question is, what if you have more latitude and longitude rows? Okay, so by default here, just like we had what we had previously, is that we have only 31 rows of coordinates. So what if you have more? What if you have more? So again, we are going to do the same approach. Let me select my coordinates and select both. Just latitude and longitude, leave alone the elevation data. Okay, so this is what I have. Let me select them, and again, let me open my Excel tool and paste my coordinate here. Okay, so as you can see here, it is written enter your coordinates. So I entered my coordinates in this column. So if you can see it closely, you can see now we have some few rows, they don't have coordinates. Remember, you don't go and select these few columns and then you double click. That is very wrong approach. What you need to do is to make sure that you unhide the hidden columns. Okay, unhide the hidden columns, and then if each and every hidden column is not hidden anymore, then you can just go and select and double click. So for me, as you can see here, we have like two areas. So this area here, we don't have like EF, we don't have G, and some other columns here, they are hidden. So I'll start with this one. Let me unhide everything. You can just double click, just like this, double click it. Okay, so for now, EFG. So at least in this area, we don't have any issue. So let me go back here and see if we have any other problem here. As you can see, we have again in this area AF, but there are some few columns that are hidden in this area. So again, we are going to do the same thing. Let me double click this to unhide the hidden columns. So for now, everything is okay. So EAFAG. Okay, so everything now is okay. So after everything now is okay, what we need to do is to make sure that we copy these columns, these rows rather, and double click. So as soon as you double click here, formulas will be copied to this additional rows. Okay, so for that you can go here and select the UTM column. Okay, so remember we are converting degrees, a decimal degrees, into UTM coordinates. So these are the converted UTM coordinates. So I need to select this, and if you can see here closely, as soon as we pasted our data, this Excel tool even select our zone and even our band. Okay, so for me, everything now is done. Let me select my coordinates all the way. Okay, everything now is selected. Let me copy and open my sample, and again let me paste it here. Okay, so now everything is perfectly fine. So what you can do, if you want, then you can even copy this UTM column, this altitude or elevation column, and paste it here. So if you are working in the project, then this is what we have. Again, let me do this. So this one here were the original data, and these ones are the converted data. So it is as simple as that, guys.